Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your extra daily dose of skill. Today we are going to play with a Stug G. I warmed up with a tank. I know how the tank feels like. And you can blame this beautiful gentleman over there, Gilgalad, for asking for this vehicle. This tank is for you, buddy. And in the same time, fellas, if you are curious about equipment setup, mark of excellence expectations, ace wanker expectations, and some other things, feel free to check out index page. It is free, right? And hopefully this will help you to progress through the game quicker and better and faster. So, without further ado, let's go into the game with a Stug and let's teleport into the round number one. And we are back to the first battle. And the quick highlights which I want to mention about this tank, speaking about the gun is very, very nice of the Stug, and this is the highlight. Also, there is two guns which you can use: derb gun, which I'm not a big fan of, and you can use the 75mm, which I am fan of. 150 penetration, 135 alpha damage, and with the gold you have 44 extra penetration and the faster shell velocity, which is always nice and always welcome. Now, how to play with a tank destroyers like Stug? You need to be patient, fellas. If you will go in front against the tier 6 and you will say, and you will make a hardcore pressure, you are going to get slaughtered, you will get banged, and you will forget your name. So you cannot do this, and it is definitely not worth it, okay? But how you can play with this tank destroyer? You can sit in the best sniper schnitzel positions, right? For example, in this kind of situation, in my humble opinion, this is one of the best sniper schnitzel positions in the game. And we are just chilling. We are enjoying ourselves and we are waiting until enemies will make one or another mistake, because oh boy, they will make a mistake. And once again, it is quite straightforward, fellas. It is not rocket science. It is quite simple gameplay, but in the same time, you need to be patient. You need to aim your shots, obviously, and you need to be patient. If you will be patient, life is going to be beautiful for you and you will have a great time. Quick highlight of all this. Now, even though if you are going to do everything ideally, there is a chance you are not going to get that much use just because enemy team is not being aggressive towards you. And this is very important thing to highlight. Also, whenever you are sitting in one or another position in the game, you need to know what to look for. For example, this gentleman, he was shooting here, hip hip hooray, but now he is not paying attention what is happening here. And as you can see yourself, there is plenty of the enemies which he could potentially farm, you know, and he could potentially shoot at. So this is very worth thing to highlight. And once again, this battle is like a dream for a Stug. It truly is. Everyone is making silly goose mistakes, enemies are chilling in the back, right, and we are farming them. I mean, there is nothing not to like in this game, right? And once again, this is perfection. When I had my warming up rounds with this vehicle to figure out what to say and what this tank is all about, because you know I cannot play with every single tank every day, so I can forget things as well. The thing is, it did not went that well, you know, when I was doing a warming up, and I noticed myself into very tricky situation whenever I simply play passively and I cannot get enough use in the game, you know. That's what I figured out in quite some situations. And now, listen, even though we are missing quite a bit of the shots, I don't really mind too much. I am just trying to hit him, and hopefully we are going to eventually start packing a sweet, sweet, sweet damage. Also, one more thing which I forgot to mention before with this tank. This tank has a very low amount of ammunition. So what that basically means? That basically means you need to be smart. You cannot shoot non-stop, because in the end of the battle you might not have potential to carry the game. For example, this battle, luckily everything is going for us and the game is not really equal, if you know what I mean. By saying this, I mean enemies do not have extremely good team, you know, and I believe it is fair to say we are winning this battle with relative ease, right? Now, if, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, if enemy team would have a better team and the situation would be 5-5 now and I have 11 rounds left and 4 high explosives, it would be kind of game over, don't you think so? So in this kind of situation, I was lucky. Our team was quite good and enemies made a mistake towards our flank. I believe we are going to get some of the worst games with this vehicle and you will see that yourself hopefully in the round 2 or round 3. And I really want to have one below average game, like where we are getting 500 damage just because we physically cannot get more use, because if we will move in front we will die, and if we will snipe from the back we won't get any use whatsoever. So I hope we are going to get game like this. And now let's finish the Su-85. Okay, Su-85 is dead, so we finished everything with 3 kills and close to 2000 damage. In fact, with a blind shot, this could be like 1.950 or something. Because if I'm not mistaken, this ELC did not add the HP for one more shot, right? If I'm not mistaken. So let's see. Moment of the truth. Do we have 2000 or we don't have 2000? This is the question. Okay, here we go. That's what we have, fellas. So we have 1994,000 damage, not even 2000. Skill, learn to play. We have a first class 400 assisting damage, which is the always nice and always welcome. 47,000 profits, which is very, very good considering this is a tier 5 shitter. And you know, nowadays you can make credits, especially on December month or January when we still have this 50x booster. Anyways, let's continue our journey and round number 2. And we are back with round 2. So what do we have here, fellas? We have a tier 7, tier 5 matchmaking, so we are bottom tier. But honestly, it doesn't really matter for a Stug, especially if you have a lot of APCR ammunition. We need to make a decision where do we want to play. And there is a couple of the plays which we can do. Option number 1 is to sit here. Option number 2 is to sit somewhere here. Option number 3 is to sit here. This is pretty much the options from which we could get plenty of use. And one more thing which I truly need to highlight. This tank has extremely, I repeat, extremely good camo rating. So even in the open field, you can kind of feel like a king, especially if you have full repair skill, full camo skill trained. Whew, I almost said repair skill, you said repair. Shit, I said. Okay. Step by step, little by little, this guy is playing Need for Speed and he is enjoying himself to the maximum. And we are trying to make sure he is going to enjoy himself. Holy bananas, this guy is meow. He's having a great time. Kudos to him. Is he going for another one? Yep. He is having a blast, fellas. I can promise you that. Anyways, this is the option number 3 position from where we can play. And we are definitely going to use this position in our advantage. So what do we want to see at this point? At this point, we have only one gentleman who is playing in the front lines. What that basically means, if enemies will try to make a bit of pressure for him, we are going to be able to find a very nice angle for the enemies. And I believe it's quite clear, Škoda is already pretty damn greedy and he might try to do some silly goose decisions. Now, looking into the HP, you can clearly see our team is winning by 2000 hit points. Even though enemy team is the one which supposed to assault, which supposed to make pressure, at this point the things can go very, very bad for us. By saying this, if enemies are not making any pressure whatsoever, this is not going to be really fun. And we cannot get involved. And even though if we can get involved, this is not going to be a fun experience and this is not going to be very good. And I believe it is quite clear at this point we are stagnating at this point. We are struggling quite a bit, and I would love to say something else, but we, but unfortunately we can't get that much use if enemies are not making mistakes towards us. And this is very, very important thing to say, truly important thing to say, fellas. Yeah, this is a hard one. Okay, look, our team is winning by humongous margin already. At this point, if we are not going to get involved and if we are not going to make pressure, we are going to finish with a score like this. And you know what? This is extremely good highlight, because playing with a tank destroyers can be tricky as F, especially if you are aiming for consistent score. If you don't really care, in one battle you are going to have 0 and in another battle you are going to have 2000, Stug as a tank destroyer is excellent, and in fact it is rated good in the index page, because I truly think the tank destroyer is very, very nice and everything is fine with it. But in the same time, it is truly worth to highlight, not every game is going to be like 2000 after 2000, and it doesn't matter how good of a player you are. A lot of things are depending on the luck in a way, as wrong as it sounds. Once again, if enemy team is not so great, and if enemy team is melting like there is no tomorrow, like for example, this team is melting, then we are going to have a score like this. And once again, it is not that bad. I think we can pump our score to 1000 at least, because we are going to approach the Tiger, and I really doubt that the Mr. Tiger is going to have an extremely good map awareness at this point, okay? At least I really doubt he has a great map awareness. I missed the first shot, doesn't really matter. We are going to get a bit closer. I don't really think gold is necessary at this point. We are going to eliminate him from the game just like so. Good, doesn't really matter, even though we are taking one for the team. And a shot to the 82, beautiful, 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 and here we go. We boosted everything to 1000, but once again, we boosted everything to 1000 for one particular reason, because we noticed we need to move in front. If we won't move in front, it is going to be GG, and I have no doubts whatsoever we will have a players who won't notice that in time, and there is nothing bad and there is nothing shameful about this, fellas. There is still a lot of space to improve, and every single of us are improving every day. You know, we are finding the new positions, we are finding the new play styles in a way. So yeah, what do we have? We have 1000, we are 5th by the damage, we are 5th by experience, we made 23,000 profits, yum yum yummy yum, and let's go for another game, let's go. And we are back, fellas. So what do we have? We have a Pilsen and we have a tier 6 matchmaking, so this is going to be quite interesting situation. So, what do we have, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen? I believe we are going to skill. What do we want to do? We want to take this position here, and hopefully from here we will be able to punish enemy forces who are trying to cross, you know? This is the whole plan. Okay, our Leo is going in front like there is no tomorrow, and that's good. Now listen, whenever enemies will try to make a pressure through the middle, we will be able to punish them. I missed the shot on Leo, I'm very, very well aware of that, but that's okay. Meanwhile, we tracked this Leo and we said, "Police, stop!" Leo is not feeling very happy, Leo is feeling quite sad, Leo is missing, and Leo is going in the garage. I'm not disturbing you, no? I'm not disturbing you, buddy, no? Okay, good. Good to hear that. Pleasure to have a business with you, sir. Okay, so let's see. I am going to load the... Do I want to load? Yeah, I'm going to load high explosive ammunition, and I want to get rid of this wall here, or of those gates here, because it is truly unnecessary for us to have this. And in the same time, if enemies will try to make a bit of pressure, we will be able to punish them, right? Ooh, Oh, hello, sunshine. How are you doing? Unfortunately, bounce to the Ruski side, but that's fine. Going for another one. Bounce once again. Luckily, this time he has a great camo. So as you can see, enemy cannot outspot us that easily. And this is the selling point of the Stug. Even though we are not sitting in the bush, in the lower tier, this camo is actually godlike, and in the lower tier, this camo is absolutely amazing. So keep this in mind, fellas. Keep this in mind. Okay, at this point, I believe it's fair to say our team is winning this game easily. So if we are not going to make pressure, this is going to be a game over, and I don't want to finish the game with 800. I want to get a bit more than that. So how we are going to get involved into this battle? We are going to go super aggressively against the T-150. I know this is not the best idea ever, and this gentleman has all advantages which he can think of, but I don't really mind too much, and we are banging him in the butt. Beautiful. How about this Sherman with a derp gun? Probably with a derp gun. No, he doesn't have a derp gun. That's okay. And all we need to do, we need to make pressure. Now, even though we are trading against this guy, it doesn't really change absolutely anything for us. And the main reason why it doesn't change anything for us, because this game is already over. Even though if I would die against the Su-100 at this point, it is literally not changing anything for our game, fellas. And once again, the quick highlight why so is because this game is already over. Our team won the battle, and this is the performance which we have. Luckily, we met some tourists in the middle which we could farm, because without those tourists it would be pretty damn sad. So let's teleport into the scoreboard. Let's go. And we are back, fellas, with a first class with 1,400 damage, 300 assisting damage. We are second by damage, we are first by experience, we made 35,000 profits, and everything went pretty good in our session with a Mr. Stug. So in the end of the day, we finished our session with 1,500 damage and 200 assisting damage, and everything went very, very well. But to be a weird, fellas, there is nothing shameful to sit in the back, right? Especially with the tanks like this. And if your team is simply beating the living crap out of the enemies, well, you know, you can't do absolutely anything in this way. And you need to accept the score which you have. Even if you did 2 shots per battle, it's completely fine. The other game is going to be better. Anyways, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for watching. I appreciate you. I hope you learned a trick or two. And greetings to you. Once again, that was your daily dose of skill. And see you very, very soon. Skill is out for today. Peace.